Hello students, welcome back. I am Rinkesh sir and our today's topic is AC voltage applied to an inductor. In the last video we had seen AC voltage applied to a resistor, then about the phasor method. Okay, so now let's draw the circuit in which AC voltage is applied to an inductor. Right, this is the AC voltage that is equal to Vm sin omega t. This is the inductor connected to the circuit. Here we will consider that the inductor have negligible resistance. Resistance. Okay, the voltage supplied by the source V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Now, if I apply the Kirchhoff's law, voltage supplied here is V, and that the voltage loss in the inductor is minus L di by dt. So minus L di by dt. This we have studied in chapter number 6, that the voltage drop across the inductor is L di by dt. That is equal to 0. Coming back to the same point, so V is equal to L di by dt. Okay, so voltage supplied, that is V, that is equal to, I can write down Vm sin omega t equal to L di by dt or di by dt, that will be equal to Vm by L sin omega t. Now let's name this equation as 1. Now we need to find out the current. So if we want to obtain the current, then we must integrate. Okay, so to integrate it, first I will rearrange like di equal to Vm by L sin omega t dt. Okay, now let's integrate. Integrating on both the sides, we will get integration of di equal to integration of Vm by L sin omega t dt. Okay, so integration of I, that will be equal to, sorry, integration of di, that will be equal to I Vm by L, that is constant, sorry, it's not capital V, it's small v. Vm by L, where Vm is the maximum voltage and L is the inductance of the inductor. Okay, that is constant. Now, integration of sine omega t. Integration of sine omega t is minus cos omega t. Okay, so I can write it down as minus cos omega t. Now, as t is multiplied by omega, so I need to divide it. Okay, plus c. Okay, because this is the integral constant. Remember, the value of C or the dimension of C will be the dimension of current, and that will be time independent. Okay, so I can write down this as I equal to minus Vm by L cos omega t by omega, or Vlg minus Vm upon omega L cos omega t. Here, since the EMF and the current both oscillate symmetrically about zero, so here we are taking the constant C as zero. Okay, so this is the equation for the current. Okay, now see, when we are taking Vm, we are taking it as Vm sin omega t. So I need to convert this cos omega d into sin. Okay, so let's write it down once again, the formula. The formula was I equal to n upon omega l cos omega d. So to convert it into sin, I can write down Vm upon omega L sine omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, how? See, if I take sine omega t minus pi by 2, so I can also write down sine pi by 2 minus omega t. Okay, means see, sine is an odd function, so I am taking minus sign here common. So it will be minus sine pi by 2 minus omega t. Okay, so this will be equal to, here we will get it as cos omega. Sorry, here again there is a mistake. See, I am solving it here. Sine omega t minus pi by 2, taking minus sign common, it will be pi by 2 minus omega t. So it will be minus sine pi by 2 minus omega t. So pi by 2 shift, so sine gets converted to cos minus cos omega t. Okay, so here it was minus, that minus gets converted to plus. Okay, so now this is the formula for the current. When we take V, then V was equal to Vm sine omega t, and in this case it is I equal to Vm by omega L sine omega t minus pi by 2. So phase difference between the voltage and current is pi by 2. I can write it down in this way also, I equal to Im sine omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, let me erase this, where Im is equal to Vm by omega L. So here it is plus or minus. Clear? So this is the maximum current, or I can say amplitude of current. Okay, clear? Here I can take omega L as XL. We will take XL as omega L. This is called inductive reactance. I write down called as inductive reactance. XL, that is inductive reactance. So that implies the maximum current Im will be equal to maximum voltage upon XL. It's just like, it plays just like the role of resistance in resistor, like I equal to V by R. So instead of resistance, it will be inductive reactance. That will be playing the role as resistance in inductor. So Im will be equal to Vm upon XL. Remember, the dimension of XL here, the dimension of XL will be equal to dimension of resistance R, and its SI unit, SI unit of XL, again it will be equal to ohm, like the resistance. Okay, so see, here we can make good comparison. Here we can make a comparison, like, see, resistor, the current was I equal to Im sine omega t, or it was Vm by R sine omega t. Here, whereas for inductor, I is equal to Im sine omega t minus pi by 2, or Vm by XL, that is inductive reactance sine omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, so it shows that current in inductor lags behind voltage by phase of pi by 2. So from here I can say that current in inductor lags behind by a phase of pi by 2. Okay, then voltage here, because V is Vm sin omega t and I is Vm by XL sin omega t minus pi by 2. So here the phase difference is pi by 2. I can also say that it's by 1/4 cycle, okay, a quarter of the cycle. Okay, one cycle, that will be the total phase difference is 2 pi. So pi by 2, that is the fourth part of it. Okay. Now let's draw the graph of voltage versus current when it is connected with inductor. And also let's draw a phasor diagram for that. Okay, now for phasor diagram, if this is the phasor or rotating vector for voltage, okay, then let's say this as omega t at any time omega t, or I can say omega t1, then the current will lag behind the voltage by a phase difference of pi by 2. So for the current, let's say this will be the current vector and this is pi by 2. Here, so current is lagging behind the voltage by a phase difference of pi by 2. Okay, means if I project it on y-axis, this will be equal to Vm sin omega t1. When I project the current, let's set this as the current, rotating vector for current of a say phasor, then when I project it here, this value will be equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Here, so this is the phasor diagram of voltage vector and current vector when an inductor is connected in a circuit. Now, if I draw the graph, okay, if I draw the graph, this will be the graph for the voltage. Okay, this is the corresponding value of the voltage at time omega t. Okay, this is the corresponding value of voltage at time omega t. Okay, let's say this is half cycle pi and this is the complete cycle 2 pi. Okay, at that time the current vector, okay, the graph for current will be in this way. Sorry. Okay, so see here, when voltage is maximum, you can see here, when voltage is maximum, that is Vm, current is zero at this point. And when current is maximum at this point, voltage is zero. Okay, so this is the corresponding value. If I want to project it, okay, then it will be this way. At this point, this is the corresponding value of current. Okay, so here you can see that voltage is zero, at that time current is in maximum in the negative direction. Okay, means the direction of current is opposite. When voltage becomes maximum, current becomes zero. When voltage becomes zero, current becomes maximum. And this difference is pi by 2. Okay, this difference is pi by 2. So current reaches the maximum value later than the voltage by a phase difference of pi by 2 or by a 1/4 period. Okay, so I can write down current reaches the maximum value later than voltage by 1/4 period. Means that is P by 4, and I can write it down it as omega, sorry, pi by 2 by omega. Okay, that phase is pi by 2, so this is the value of omega t. Okay, when omega t is p by 4, that's the pi by 2 by omega. Okay, so how does this come, t by 4 equal to pi by 2 by omega? Because when for one complete period t is equal to capital T, and the phase difference that will be 2 pi. So we want t by 4 time, so it's pi by 2, so t by 4 equal to pi by 2 by omega. Okay, remember, current reaches the maximum value later than voltage by 1/4 period, or the phase difference between current and voltage is pi by 2, means current is lagging behind the voltage by a phase difference of pi by 2. Now let's see the power supplied to an inductor. Okay, power supplied to an inductor. Okay, we already found out the current flowing through inductor. Now let's see power supplied to an inductor. Okay, so the instantaneous power supplied to inductor. Power supply the inductor. So let's write down PL, L for inductor. And we know the formula for power is VI. Okay, what is V? Vm sine omega t. And I, Im sine omega t minus pi by 2. So omega t minus pi, sine omega t minus pi by 2, that will be minus cos omega t. So minus Vm sine omega t Im cos omega t. I have taken this minus sign. Rearranging, minus Vm into Im. Sine omega t cos omega t. Let's multiply by 2. Divide by 2. Okay, so the power supplied to the inductor, that is minus Vm into Im by 2, and 2 sin theta cos theta, that will be equal to sin 2 theta, so that will be sin 2 omega t. So this is the instantaneous power supplied to the inductor. Okay, this is the formula for instantaneous power supplied to the inductor. But if I want to find out the average power, okay, for average power, that is average of PL, that will be average of minus Vm Im by 2 sine 2 omega t. Now we know that for one complete cycle, the average of sine is 0. So this implies average power is 0. The average power supplied to the inductor, that is equal to 0. Okay, so I can write down average power supplied to an inductor over one complete cycle is 0. But see, the instantaneous power is not 0, that is minus Vm Im by 2 sine 2 omega t. Okay, so this was about the power supplied to an inductor. This was about the complete part, AC voltage supplied to an inductor. Okay, we had found out the current flowing through an inductor when AC voltage is supplied. We had used the phasor diagram. We drawn the graph of V and I versus omega t. And then we found out the power supplied to an inductor. Okay, so just note down this topic. Okay, students, so that's it for today. Thank you.